In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a bass shake effect in Premiere Pro. Let's get to it. Here we are in Premiere. I've got this video of some people dancing and the non-copyright music that we're going to sync the bass shake to. Now, first thing you want to do is to give yourself some space by expanding the audio track so you can see the peaks. This is generally where the beat drops happen. Or you can go ahead and listen to the song so you can locate the exact position of the beat drops. So once you've found them, you want to move the time indicator to the first beat drop. Select the audio layer and press M on the keyboard to place a marker. And we're going to use these markers to sync the effect with the beat drops perfectly. So continue doing that for the rest of the song. And once you've placed all of the markers accordingly, you want to add an adjustment layer. So click on this new item icon and select adjustment layer. Make sure it matches the sequence settings. Click OK, then drag and drop it to the timeline above the video. Then open effects window and search for directional blur. Then add it to the adjustment layer, then head over to the effect controls panel, and under the directional blur settings, you want to increase the blur length as you see fit. I like to go for 40, you can increase it higher if you want. And then what you want to do is to zoom into the timeline nicely, select the eraser tool, and we're going to cut the adjustment layer into one frame pieces. So just go one frame at a time and create cuts in the adjustment layer. After that, I'm going to switch back to the selection tool. I'm going to remove the rest of the adjustment layer. And here we're going to remove every other one frame piece that we've cut. So 1, 2, 3, and you can leave 3 or 4. I like to have 3, so I'm going to remove the last one and leave just the 3 pieces. And then what we want to do is to select these and move them to the first marker that we've placed. So here, and then we are going to duplicate these and move them to the next marker. Now you can select them all, hold the Alt key on the keyboard, drag on any of them and move them over, and that'll duplicate all 3 of the adjustment layer pieces. Or you can click on this V1 to deselect the first track, then select the V2, and now once the V2 is selected, you can select these adjustment layers, press Ctrl C to copy them, and move the time indicator to the next marker, and press Ctrl V, and I'll paste these into the track number 2. And then continue doing that until you are done. And after you've placed all of the adjustment layers accordingly at the positions of the markers, you can go ahead and preview this. And this will give us a simple bass shake effect applied to the video. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.